Picasso has a beautiful movie. Have you seen this movie where he stands behind the canvas? Of course, he's drinking his wine and he's sitting in his chair behind. He puts one thing up and then he puts another thing up and you see a fish. It's the haiku of form. He does one more stroke and you see a duck. Then he does three more strokes and you see a house, and then you see your little girl walking into your house. It's all of 11 strokes. And Picasso, of course, did this in his Man Smoking a Pipe. There, he really pushed us. Picasso was maybe the greatest image understander we've ever had. He totally shattered the surface. He made it contradictory, yet always there was the concept of the man smoking the pipe. So we've been trying to do this for shape and form and function in medical images. And that's what computational anatomy is. Now, our greatest image understanding systems are artists and painters. And you yourself can think about what Seurat was doing when he created pointillism. So you start with the canvas, and the canvas has thousands and thousands of points. And there's no notion of a knowledge representation. There's no notion of the house in the point, or of the person in the point. That's a deeper construct. Being able to have a machine take a 3D magnetic resonance image and go from the order 1 billion measurements to a declarative statement, like this person has a myocardial infarction, is quite challenging. And we don't have any machines that can literally go from the many, many measurements to knowledge representations. And that really is the holy grail of image understanding. We don't do this because somebody else says it's a good idea. If somebody else says it's a good idea, it means it's already out there. I say this to all my students all the time. If when you write a paper that you think is an important paper, if it doesn't get completely destroyed in review, it's not an interesting paper. Right? I mean, that's just the way it is. So, you know, when we first wrote Computational Anatomy, we submitted it to a particular journal. I knew the editor. The reviews that came back were scandalous. And you just have to believe in what you're doing. You have to do what you know is cool and you believe in, and then it always turns out.